Now students, I hope you understood all meaning of all keywords. Now that day we have started that French Revolution, that introductory part, how people they distracted that Bastille Fort, and afterwards also we have discussed about the French society during late 18th century. You can easily be understand this is the main their first estate clergy, second estate nobility, and third estate that the big businessmen, merchants, then officials, all at that part only. And the most important thing that though society was divided into three categories, but 90% population they only belong from the farmer group, and only a small number of them own the land they cultivated. Means though 90% of the population, means out of 100, 90 people they belong from peasant category, from farmers, but they only small number of farmers they had own land. Fine. And out of them 60% of the land was owned by the nobles, the church, and other richer member of the third estate. So the member of the first two estates, that is the clergy and the nobility, enjoyed certain privileges by birth, and the most important of these was exemption of paying taxes to the state. Means though the first two categories they enjoyed all kind of privileges or facilities available in that society, but they were exempted from the paying tax. They did not pay tax to anybody. Only two types of tax, that is of tithe and tally, they mainly paid by the third estate only. Now your next topic, given the struggle to survive, means people how they struggle, how they had to struggle to survive their life. First one, what about their situation? Just see the struggle to survive, rapid increase in population. First problem was their rapid increase in population, means population rapidly growing there, rapid increase in demand for food grains. So whenever population will be increased, definitely that time food demand also be more there. So though population increase day by day, their food demand also be increasing day by day. And wages could not match rising prices, means that kind of requirement they had, maybe for surviving a family, if they required 500 rupees in a day, such kind of amount they were not getting as wages. So that wages also could not match rising prices, though prices were rising, but wages was the same there. Drought or hail further made the situation worse. And another also due to drought, that time crops also be failure there, that's why situation was worse. And that and subsistence crisis also be there, and that is the reason of outbreak of revolution. Your next topic, that is of outbreak of the revolution. What is the meaning? Means how people started revolt against the king. Why they revolted against the king? First one, monarch could not impose taxes as his will. He needed approval of estate general to pass the proposal. Means not like that, that taxes mainly fixed by the state. It was not at the will of king. Actually, before granting that bill, they had to take permission from estate general. And who are the member of estate general? Three groups are there, that the clergy, nobility, and another one, third estate there. King called estate general to pass tax proposal. Just like in our country also, whenever government tried to pass any bill, that time they have to call all members of that assembly, and after discussions only, after discussions and after when all will be agree with that, that time government can pass any bill. Like that, king also called state general to pass tax proposal. Then afterwards what happened? Voting to be conducted on the basis of one state, one vote. Not like that, just like in India. Here, one person, one value, one vote is here. But not like that in France. What happened there that time? Three states were there and each state had power to cast one vote. Though in first state, total members were there 200 and in second state, total members there of 300 and in third state, total representatives were there 600. Though all having right to cast single vote, just like first state, though 200 representatives are there, but only single vote will be counted there. And from second state to one vote. And third state, though more members are there, but there only we can count single vote. So what happen if any kind of proposal be granted by that person that time? Who will be the winner? First and second state, because they can, their two votes only be counted, but third state only single vote. So that all everything only passed according to their desire, according to their wish only. So that voting to be conducted on the basis of one state, one vote, it only be discrimination was there. Third state, that's why few proposals, third state was not agreed with that. So that they walked out when the demand of one member, one vote denied. There, what they demanded? They demanded single person, single vote, but that totally be denied by the king. That's why they walked away, they left that assembly, because their demand was not granted by the king. And after leaving that place, third state met and at an indoor tennis court, that is in Versailles, and founded National Assembly and draft a constitution for France. That the group member of third state, they totally be disobeyed king, and at the place of tennis court, they assembled there, they gathered there, and they made their own constitution, and also they made a National Assembly. Then king ordered to suppress agitating crowd, led to the storming on Bastille. Last of all, what happened in the on 14 July 1789, Bastille was totally stormed, totally destroyed by a large crowd. So this is the means outbreak. The main reason was their political rights were totally be denied. That's why people revolt against the king in France.